Hey guys, James Wedmore here with a really quick yet really cool trick that you can do with YouTube. And we're going to start out by addressing the elephant in the room. And the big problem and the big complaint people have with YouTube is, well, I create this video, someone watches my video, and then when the video ends, you get this. All these other related videos that have nothing to do with me, my business. In fact, they could be my competitor. They're going to go on, watch that video, and never come back to you. And the average person is spending almost 20 minutes a day watching YouTube videos. So the last thing you want to do is get them off of your channel and onto your competitors or something that's going to distract them, right? So how do we solve this? Well, there's two ways. There's one way that most people know already. It's if you're going to share your video or embed it on your blog, you can remove this option that says show suggested videos when the video finishes. So you want to make sure that if you're going to put a video on your blog or embed it somewhere else, that you unclick that option. Everyone already knows that. Okay, that's a no-brainer one. What I want to show you is something a little bit more sneaky. Okay, so what we're going to do is I'm going to actually go to my video. This is one of my videos right here. And we'll mute it so you don't get to hear my voice twice. It's called Make Videos Online More Engaging. And what I do at the end of this video is I have a call to action. Now, let's get rid of this call to action overlay. This is my call to action at the end of the video. I just have my little video up here that they can click on and go to my next video. That's all I want them to do. Now, they can go to videotrafficacademy.com, that's fine, but I really just want them to go to this next video. Now, there's one way that people are suggesting that we do this, and it's in the editing room, make the video really long at the end. But then what that does is that makes this really long. It makes your time really long. It'll have you a 10-minute video because you made the ending 5 minutes long. You don't want to do that. So how do we solve that problem? Well, watch this little trick. When you're logged into your account, which I am right here, you're going to have all these edit buttons above your video. Click the edit annotations button. And all right, I'll shut that up. Okay. And then what you want to do is you're going to click add annotation and you're going to add the pause annotation. Oh yes. The pause annotation. Let me do that correctly. Now you can put this wherever you want in your video, right? You get to move it around and all that stuff. So you get to put it wherever you want in the video and you can make it as long as you want. So the smart thing would be to put it at the very end of your video, right before it officially ends, and pause it for a good 30 seconds to a minute, even longer. Okay, now I'm not going to go ahead and do that because I already have this one in place. So we're going to go ahead and look at it in action. Okay, let's get rid of this. Let's get rid of this. And let's go watch the end of this video again, and I'll show you how this works. So what I want you to do is you see my call to action comes up, and you can see my video, and this is what I want people to click on. That's what we're all, aiming at. Now watch what happens. See the timer, it's set 7, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, wait for it, 16. It's staying on, stuck on 16. The screen isn't moving and there's this little timer right there in the upper left-hand corner. That goes away and then it keeps counting. Guys, it's as simple as that. Add an annotation to the end of your videos when your call to action appears with a pause button, and that'll keep you from having the video officially end and moving on to the related videos. It's a powerful little trick. Go add it to all of your videos right now.